Alright guys, today I'll be showing you my new Dermestid Beetle colony. I bought them so I could clean out some skulls more efficiently than boiling them. Started out with 50 of them a couple weeks ago, and they're breeding pretty good. Probably have a couple thousand in there now. So basically, what we got is all these little larvae, and they do most of the eating. The adults basically just lay eggs. They don't eat anything. And right now, I've got a mallard duck skull. I just put it in, came straight out of the freezer, so it's going to need to warm up a little bit before they can eat too much of it. But as you can see, a couple minutes in, and they're already starting to swarm it. A couple starting to eat it. At the moment, I have just taken out, about 2 hours ago, two turkey skulls. And it is impossible to get all the little larvae off by hand because there's so many little nooks and crannies. So I have put the skulls in a plastic bin and in the corner somewhere. Ah, there. I have put some freezer-burned bluegill fillet, try to lure them out, and as you can see, they're starting to come out of the skull onto that. So after I've got the skulls out, I degrease them in acetone, and I actually just finished degreasing some a couple hours ago, so I don't have any left to show you. But after I degrease them, I whiten them in peroxide. This is the first time I've tried the cream form of peroxide. I use volume 40. The clear liquid works really well. So after that, they come out really white. I left my finished products upstairs, and I'm too lazy to go up there, so I'll get those in another video. These beetles are not the easiest things to keep. It's not just a set it and forget it, but they're not very high maintenance, and they're not picky. Basically, you're just going to want a glass tank, some bedding. What I have is cotton, paper towel on top, and basically you're just going to feed them dry-ish meat if you can. Take a lot of the stuff out of the skull before you introduce it to the beetles, just so it's easier for them. Takes a lot less time and it's easier to clean up later. Now, what you want to do with watering them is real careful. You don't want to get the tank too wet or you'll get mold and mites and then your whole colony will die. So you've spent a lot of time building these guys up and then they all die, so that's not good. When you water them, you want a spray bottle like this. Just any water will do. And a couple ways you can do it is, as you can see, I have some balled up paper towels. You can spray them down, and you can also spray the specimen that you're trying to have them clean if it starts to get dried out. And basically what that does is it keeps the water out of the bedding, so that way it doesn't sit there very long. If the beetles don't finish this, it will evaporate in about 2 hours. Some guys I know, they put little bowls with cotton balls in there, bowls of water, just enough so that the cotton is moist but not soaking wet. Now up in Edinburgh it's kinda cold right now, probably 20 degrees, so in the basement it's around 40 degrees, but these guys don't really get going until about 80 to 85 degrees, and that is why I have this heat lamp. The beetles do not appreciate the light very much. They will eat in the light, as you can see. They were going on that duck and that bluegill over there, but they prefer to eat in the dark. So I use a purple bulb or a black bulb just because it puts off more light and it makes them more comfortable. It also gives off more heat than a regular white bulb. Another thing that will make them eat faster is if you put a covering over your skulls. They will like that better. Probably put this paper towel. Usually paper towel or cardboard works pretty well. And if you wanted to get real fancy, you can put little chunks of styrofoam in with them, and what they do there is they burrow into it and lay their eggs. They'll tear it to shreds, and once they do that, you can just take them out, scoop it out, clean up your tank, and put them over some hardware cloth. Just dump it on there. And what they will do is they will crawl out of the bedding and fall through the hardware cloth. And you can just put the cloth over like a plastic bin like this will be fine. These beetles will eat any organic material except for bone that you could give them. On the mallard duck, they will actually eat all of this beak covering. It's kind of like a leathery texture. It's very hard, and they will actually still eat that. They will eat all the cartilage, anything but bone. And that's why I like these guys as opposed to boiling them, because some of the more delicate bones in the smaller animals and the nasal cavities and your deer and stuff. Also, this eliminates the problem of grease stains. Sometimes when you boil them, you set the grease in the skull, and your smaller bones will actually dissolve in the water. These are some bones found inside a turkey's eye, and as you can see, they are very thin, and these will definitely dissolve. You can see that guy crawling on my finger, and they actually will not bite you because they only eat dead stuff, which is kind of convenient if you're handling them a lot. So that's my basic setup, and acetone you can find anywhere. These fish tanks, it's fine from Walmart. This is the peroxide I use, and I believe the 16 fluid ounce were on sale at Sally's Beauty Supply. You can buy these in bulk too. They have them in gallons. These are the creams I just bought. They're real cheap, so that's pretty much all you need to get started doing these guys. And one more thing I want to mention is a lot of people ask me, well, don't they stink? That depends. Like, downstairs, I have them right now in this basement, so no one's really going to complain about too much stink. I mean, we do all kind of animal processing down here, keeping minnows and stuff, but basically, if you keep it dry, it will stink less. The less meat you put in, the less it will stink. The beetles themselves don't smell. It's just what you put in there. Dry meat, freezer burn, won't give off a stink at all. Some people say, well, can't you just put a lid on it and that will eliminate the smell from spreading? You'll actually kill the beetles, because what smell they do put off, it'll just get too concentrated and you'll actually kill them. When you get a large number of beetles so that they can eat a skull like this quickly, it's not going to stink for very long, maybe 40 minutes, because after that, whatever's left will dry out and they will have eaten the rest of the meat already. It doesn't have time to rot, and if you have too thick of a piece of meat so it starts to rot in the middle, they won't eat it and you'll get flies in there and it's a big mess. And I do actually have a crap ton of beetles in here, but since I turned the light on about 40 minutes ago, they're burying themselves in all those tiny little holes are their dens, and these guys are just braving it out here. When they're finished eating, they'll go all up under the bedding and inside of it. So if you guys want to get started doing this, all you got to do is find some either a local taxidermy shop, he'll get you started if he has them, or you can buy them online. Skull Taxidermy is the name of one of the websites, and they're pretty good. You don't want to buy them off eBay, because sometimes they can get mites in them, and your guys off eBay haven't been doing this long enough to know how to ship them right. So that's it for today, and good luck. I'll make another video when I'm ready to degrease this duck. See you guys.